हाय स्टूडेंट्स, सो द लास्ट फ्यू डेज ऑनवर्ड्स देयर इज ऑनलाइन क्लास आर गोइंग ऑन टू यू टू नो द सम बेसिक्स ऑफ द स्टडीज. नाउ द कंटिन्यूस ऑफ द बेसिक टॉपिक टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट वन मोर टॉपिक अबाउट ए प्लांट्स. सो अलोंग विद अस वी हैव लाइफ. The life, you need some necessities to continue well. So, if you would like to get in a proper life, everybody must need food. We should take the food which are very nutrient food. So, what type of nutrient food we should take? That is already we have discussed in the previous class. Now, we are going to discussing about how the plants are can prepare their food. So this is the basic of we know already in the previous class. Now we are going to be learning about how the plants can prepare their food. So we have a life as well as the plants also have some life. They can prepare their food also. In our environment, no, all plants can prepare the food, but the plants only can prepare the food. We are depending on plants for getting the food. We cannot prepare our food by our own. So in our nature, the plants only can prepare their food. Even though not all plants can prepare the food, just some plants which are have contained some specialized organelles in their body, they only can prepare their food. So what plants can prepare their food? How they can prepare the food? What is called photosynthesis? That is we are going to be learning today in the class. Okay, so coming to the topic about the plants, we know the plants are mainly they have specialized parts. We can find out plants have two type of the parts, like in a two type of systems. One is called shoot system and another one is called root system. Shoot system and root system. A root system means which is a system is presented inside of the soil. Which is a system presented inside of the soil, it is called root system. Which is a system is presented above the soil, that is called shoot system. In that root system, the main parts are roots. But in the shoot system, the main parts are stems, leaves, flowers, fruits, some branches we can see find out. These all are the parts of belongs to the shoot system. Okay, these are some parts are present in the plants. You know, we have some information how the root system presented, how the type of this root system presented, what type of parts already you learned in the previous classes, what you have studied. But now we are learning some update the topic of that, so about the plant and their fruit photo system. So we know about the plants and the one of the process I said about the photosynthesis. The word photosynthesis is called the plants can prepare the food by their own method. The plants can prepare the food by their own method. The process which is helping for preparing the food to the plant, it is called as photosynthesis. The word photosynthesis, here is the word. The photo means light. Photo means light and synthesis means they can making the preparation, the making, they are preparing the food, the making method of the food, synthesized to preparing, the preparation method is called synthesize, the making or preparation, that's the method. By using of the light, the plants can prepare by making their food, that is the process called photosynthesis. By that method, the plants can prepare their food. that budget, the plants can prepare their food. Okay, that is a process called photosynthesis. And we have to know what type of the plants can prepare their food by the process of the photosynthesis. Which type of the plants cannot prepare their food by the photosynthesis process. Some are can prepare their food, some are unable to prepare their food. So in our nature, there are two type of ovules. One is called as autotrophs. And another one is called heterotrophs. Autotrophs and heterotrophs. The meaning of the word autotrophs means called the plants which can prepare the animal organisms which can prepare their food, it is called as autotrophs. The organism which cannot prepare their food by their own, that's called heterotrophs. Example of the autotrophs are plants. Example of the autotrophs are plants, but not all plants, only the green plants. Why the green plants only can prepare the food, that I will explain you when the topic is going on. Okay, the green plants can prepare the food as well as algae. We also look like green color. Algae we can find it, and from water we can find some type of the plants which are green color. Those are called algae plants. And water we can find out where the place of the board is in the place. Some type of green material is present that looks like a plant. Those are called as algae. They also can prepare their food as well as some type of the bacteria also can prepare their food. And heterotrophs, which are the organisms that cannot prepare their food, that is the process, that is the organisms are called as heterotrophs. Example of heterotrophs are we are human beings. All animals, we are animals, all cannot prepare their food. Why can't we prepare the food? Why plants can prepare the food? Why can't animals prepare the food? Why some plants which are green color they could prepare the food? That will be discussing now. Okay, so coming to that, by the process of the photosynthesis, the plants can prepare their food. By the process of the photosynthesis, the plants can prepare their food. So what type of the materials are it need? Plants are especially they need some ingredients in a pot like. If you would like to prepare any food, we need some ingredients. If you would like to prepare any like a chicken biryani, if you would like to prepare, we need some rice. We need some fragrant materials. We need rice, water. We need and chili powder. The different items are we need for preparation of the food. As well as if the plants also want to prepare their food, they also need some ingredients. Those are called photosynthetic factors. Those are called photosynthetic factors. Those photosynthetic factors are, one is sunlight, and chlorophyll, and water, and carbon dioxide, CO2, carbon dioxide. These four are photosynthetic factors are need for the photosynthesis process. We know discuss photosynthesis. The meaning is called photo means light. This means making a preparation. The plants can preparing their food by using of the light. The light means not I'm telling about the like a tube light lighting or electric power supply lighting. Not that is I'm saying that the light which can be available from sun. The one and only source for getting the primary energy source in our nature that is available from sun, it's called sunlight. The plants can prepare their food by using the sunlight, they can prepare their food. And chlorophyll means, I have told you only green plants only can prepare their food. That means which are the plants have chlorophyll. The chlorophyll means the green color pigment. Green color pigment. It is present in the place of the chloroplast. It's present in chloroplast. Chloroplast is one organelle, one part. In that part contains the pigment material is called chlorophyll. That chlorophyll can help to prepare the food in a plant.
and
some type of the plant. I told you the green plant. Some plants only can prepare their food. Some are cannot prepare. That means which are the plants have chlorophyll? They can prepare their food. Those are called autotrophs. Which are the plants have no chlorophyll? They cannot prepare their food. Those are called heterotrophs. And next one is called water. To prepare the food in a plant, they must need a water. That means the plants are absorb water from soil by the work of the root. The root system is absorbing water from the soil. And CO2, it is called carbon dioxide. If this is a carbon dioxide is available in nature, in atmosphere it is available. That means we are taking oxygen, we are releasing carbon dioxide. Plants are taking carbon dioxide, they are releasing oxygen. Okay, but remember one thing, if anybody asks you, who can prepare, what type of the gas the plants are taking, what type of the gas animals, that means we are taking, if anybody asks a question, we can say, plants are taking carbon dioxide and they are releasing oxygen, and animals are taking oxygen, releasing carbon dioxide. We are saying this also, but not exactly right. At the time of the respiration, I mean to say, at the time of the breathing time, animals like human beings, all animals are can take the oxygen. I'm telling that one. At the time of respiration time, in the mean breathing time, we also taking oxygen, as well as plants also taking oxygen. Remember, it's very, very important. Somebody are confusing when you're saying, when you're asking this question. At the time of the respiration time, plants also taking oxygen, and animals like human beings also taking oxygen. Plants also releasing carbon dioxide, as well as human beings also, and animals also releasing carbon dioxide. But you have to, we are saying the plants are taking carbon dioxide. Plants are taking carbon dioxide during the time of the photosynthesis, not in the respiration time. The whole respiration is a breathing process. The respiration is in every animal, in every living organism, the respiration method is constant. Every animal, every organism at the time of the respiration time, they are taking oxygen only, they are using carbon dioxide only. But especially the plants have two types of functions. The respiration also they have. At the time of respiration time, they are taking oxygen, they are using carbon dioxide as well as like us. But at the time of the, when the time of light available, sunlight available time, they are taking carbon dioxide, they are using oxygen. That means two methods are happening in the plants. When sunlight available time, the plants are participating in photosynthesis process. At that time, they are taking carbon dioxide, they are using oxygen. When the time of there is no sunlight is available, the plants are participating in respiration time. That time, the plants are also taking oxygen, releasing carbon dioxide. It's very important. Okay, so now we are discussing about sunlight, chlorophyll, water, carbon dioxide. By using these all, the plants can prepare their food by the process of the photosynthesis. I said the water can be absorbed from the soil. Next one is CO2, carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide, it is present in the place of atmosphere. How plants can take the carbon dioxide? For this one, they have a part, it is the present in the leaves. Leaves are helpful for absorbing gases, means like carbon dioxide. The leaf has some specialized part, the part is called as stomata. The part is called stomata. A tiny holes are presented on the leaf. The small tiny holes which are helping for exchanging of the gas, taking oxygen, releasing carbon dioxide, or taking carbon dioxide, releasing oxygen. Any other one. At the time of respiration time also, or maybe that photosynthesis time also, the stomatas are, which is present in the place of the leaf, they are helping for exchanging of the gases. Okay, so the plants are taking these materials when the sunlight, chlorophyll, water, CO2, these four conditions are properly available for the plant, the plants can participate in the process of the photosynthesis process. Can participate in photosynthesis process. For this one, there is a small formula also there, we know that is called carbon dioxide. Less water usage to glucose plus oxygen plus water. It's a formula for photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide plus water gives to chlorophyll. Carbon dioxide plus water gives to glucose, oxygen, water. You can find out there is chlorophyll and oxygen. That means the plants are taking carbon dioxide from atmosphere and water from soil, and they have contained already chlorophyll, and they can use it is a sorry sunlight. They can use chlorophyll and sunlight. They can prepare the food. That food material is called as glucose. That means the food we are taking, that is the material is called glucose. So the plants are using carbon dioxide and water. By using of the chlorophyll and the presence of sunlight, they can prepare the food, that is called glucose. The food is called glucose. Along that also they can release oxygen and water. This oxygen will be coming out synthetic in the atmosphere. That is the oxygen we are taking. That same oxygen we are taking. We are using carbon dioxide. That carbon dioxide plants are taking. They convert into oxygen. That oxygen we are taking. We are using carbon dioxide. Again the plants are taking. That is going on like in a cycle. So, and also they can release water. Extra water is leaving outside. The plants are taking water from the soil. Excess water, which is the water is extra portion is all the water, which is the water is unnecessary water is presented, that water will be sent outside. Excess water. After the process of photosynthesis. So this is the method of the photosynthesis. That means the plants are using carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, they can prepare the glucose. The food can be stored in the plants. The plants can store the food in a different parts. I mean to say like in the leaves they can store, or in a fruit they can store, or in a stem part they can store, or in a flower part they can store. The plants can store in a different parts, even in the root part also can store the food. Plants can store the food in leaf, or maybe in a fruit part, or maybe in a stem part, or maybe in a flower part, or maybe in a root part. Different plants can store their food in different parts. Example of some plants which can be stored their food in a leaf, like when you're eating some type of the leafy food, like in a amaranthus, coriander, or like in a what's called hemp, spinach, mint. These type of the plants can store their food in a leaf. And fruits, some type of the plants are stored their food in a fruits. Example like mango, apple, grape, guava, you're saying that is also the fruit. As we can say like any vegetables are also example of the fruits. That means we are using the food for the making of food, that's why it's called vegetables. But that is also fruit part, like a drumstick also fruit part, like a brinjal also fruit part, and cucumber also fruit part. That thing is called fruit part. Example of tomato, these all are stem. Some type of these plants can store their food in the place of stem part. Example of underground stem like any potato. They can store the food in a stem part. Okay, so this is an example. And also the flower part. We know like in flowers are example like in a cauliflower and broccoli. Cauliflower and broccoli, these are some example of the plant which can store the food in a flower. And root part. That means some type of the organisms can be stored the food in the place of root part. Example of carrot, beetroot. These are examples. So these type of the organisms can prepare the food, and they can store the food in the place of the inside of the fruits, or inside of the root, or inside of the flower, or leaf, or in the stem. It is a process. Done in the place only in a some type of the plants. not all plants. Why? Because only some plants can prepare the food which have a contents of the chloroplast. What about that? The remaining of the plants, how can they survive? The plants which are just store the food that is we are taking from the plant, we are preparing the food what we need. But sometimes all the plants are cannot prepare their food. Which are the plants prepare their food? They are storing their food. They can use the food when they are taking a rest of the position, right? So what is the food? The plants are storing the food for the continuity of their life. But we are taking the food which is prepared by plants. So this is about some plants which can prepare the food. I am telling you about autotrophs. But I am saying that is some type of the plants are cannot prepare the food. Some type of the plants are unable to, they can prepare the food. How they can survive? They can be survived by depending on others. They are depending on others. Some type of like a donor is a one type of the plant. Donor is a one type of the plant. It is cannot prepare their food. They have no leaves. For they have some type of the roots they have, which are look like a spine roots, which are sharp roots. The roots are injecting into the which are the plants are preparing their food. That means here is a plant can prepare the food. This is a daughter plant cannot prepare the food. Then what will happen? The plant roots are can be injecting into the stem of the this plant. So what is the food prepared by this plant that will be taken by this plant? They both can be exchanging. So this is the process of the plants can prepare the process of the photosynthesis. If the photosynthesis is done well, the plants can be survived well. If the photosynthesis are not done well, the photosynthesis are not done. If the photosynthesis are done well, they can prepare their food. That is the food we are using. So, if they are not providing food, we can't continue our life. Every animal in our nature depending upon the plants only. The main source of the energy in our nature is sunlight. By sunlight can prepare the food, that is the food we are taking also. If we are not there, no plant, because of they need carbon dioxide for preparing the food. If we are not there, plants are not there. If plants are not there, we are also not there. The both have some type of the relationship we are maintaining. The relationship which can help me to be surviving our life healthy and happily. Helping for surviving our life healthy and happily. That is the method of the photosynthesis method. Okay, I hope you can understand that this is. So, it is a very important topic for that topic. You can participate in the respiration process. I am saying that is once again to you, that is the topic is, the plants when the time of the respiration time. At the time of respiration time, plants are taking oxygen and they are releasing carbon dioxide at the time of the respiration time. At the time of the photosynthesis time, the plants are also taking carbon dioxide, they are releasing oxygen. Respiration time, they are taking oxygen, releasing carbon dioxide. Photosynthesis time, they are taking carbon dioxide, releasing oxygen. And coming to be the human beings and animals are, we have only the process of respiration. At the time, we are taking oxygen, we are releasing carbon dioxide. So, it is a process which is happening. So, the coming class of how it is happening in respiration methods and how it is happening that one, what is the importance of these methods are, and that is about we can discuss in the next class. Thank you.